Okay, well, welcome to Live with Maryann, Mondays with Maryann, and I am live here in the Central Pennsylvania Food Bank Kitchen. Almost had a moment there, folks. It is a Monday. So glad you could join me today. We're getting the scoop on potatoes, and I want to know who of you knows the mashed potato. Who knows how to do that? Donna? Oh, Heidi, come on, I need some tips. How to do the mashed, oh, there we go, the mashed potato. Come on, do it with me. Everybody get that exercise in. At your desk, here we go, I see Nellie, yeah, get down. Okay, so we are gonna scoop on potatoes today, but I'm gonna announce the winner of last month's avocado live, which was Monica Ross. Monica won a beautiful single-use blender for making all those special smoothies and mixing things like avocados to a paste. And Monica, this is coming your way. And so we're excited that she joined us. If you take part in our polls today, you also will be registered to win today's prize. What is it? You want to know. It's actually a wonderful kitchen assortment from the food bank. We have a beautiful apron, nicer than the one I'm wearing, by the way. We have some measuring things. We have a beautiful bamboo mini cutting board, a beautiful pie plate for maybe you to do some scalloped potatoes in. You want to win, so make sure you participate. We'll let you know next month who's the winner. All right, so we're going to get started. We're actually going to make two recipes today, so I'm going to get started before I pump you for some information. So today's first recipe is buffalo potato wedges. Have anybody ever made these? Putting a spin on those unhealthy chicken wings that we all love and adore with that crispy skin and that high fat. And we're going to make them healthier by using something that everybody at the food bank usually gets during distribution, which would be potatoes. So it's a great way to use them in a different way and still satisfy some of those maybe unhealthier cravings that you have. And so I'm really excited for this. We're going to start that. But while I'm cutting up my potatoes to put in my oven, we're going to do a poll and we're going to see how much information you know about potatoes. Put it up, Nellie. All right, so the first one, what's your favorite way to eat potatoes? Let's see what everybody out there thinks. Your favorite way, and I know some of you like them all, but you must pick one for the poll. And no, I did not add potato chips just because I felt like that was not going to be a good option. We are the nutrition department here at the Central Pennsylvania Food Bank, and so we want to encourage you to healthier eating. And so we're going to have you do that. Number two, what's the average person in the United States consumes how many pounds of potatoes a year? I don't know. My cousin that I was with this weekend, she was hitting that potato salad hard. All of the potato salads. I think she probably doubles her intake. So here I'm just cutting these potatoes, red and white, up into nice little wedges, all the same size, while you are answering this. Have some tricky ones on there. We're going to give you a little culture, as in who did the famous potato eaters' beautiful, world-renowned picture, famous artist.
Come on.
So who actually produces the most potatoes? Are they grown everywhere? Are they grown in your backyard? And true or false, the potato was the first vegetable grown in outer space. Is everybody done with their poll? You can put your hand up maybe if you're done with the poll. We'll know everybody's ready to move on. I just saw
that. I'm on it, but I can't get it bigger.
You can't get what bigger?
Your picture. Hi, oh, Maryann. No.
Hi, Shirley. That's my technological friend who's trying to get in there. It's okay. You can just yell out your answer, Shirley. So here I have a bunch of red and white potatoes.
Okay, are you on?
Yeah, you can turn off your microphone, Shirley. All right, so I see the first question up there. Your favorite way to have potatoes. Now this is a winner any way you slice it because it's your favorite way. And what's the answer on that one? It flashed before my eyes.
It looks like we have a tie. Well, baked seems to be the winner.
Baked potatoes. Okay, a great easy way to get your potatoes in for the week. Just pop them in the microwave or the oven. Easy to eat. I see some French fries coming up there. Me, myself, I like roasted potatoes. Love that crisp skin. Just keep the skin on them. Put them in the oven with a little bit of olive oil, which is kind of how we start out this recipe for these buffalo potato wedges. So I have my potatoes cut up in the bowl. There's about 8 potatoes cut up in there. I'm going to use 2 tablespoons of olive oil to toss on there. Heart healthy olive oil. You want to be using that. Okay, just get them a little crispy. And then we're just going to put as much salt, pepper, and garlic powder as Maryann wants. Because guess who gets to try these later? And anybody who's in the office, come on down afterwards. All right, so we're just going to sprinkle a little salt on there. Okay, want to keep the sodium down, but that's usually not where you get most of your sodium. It's usually through packaged products. So you want to stay away from those packaged products, especially even those potato packaged products, because they have a lot of sodium in them. So we have some salt, some pepper, we have some garlic powder. I'm a little heavy on the garlic girl. So we're just gonna put that on there. We're just gonna toss these. And by the magic of television and with my new assistant here, Maria, we're actually going to just put these in the oven. And so as you can see, easy peasy. And then you can go off and do something like a workout while they're cooking, right? That's what we all do. So we're going to take those, we're going to put those in the oven on a cookie sheet.
Maryann, I have a question. I'm sorry. What potatoes are you using now?
I'm just using a regular red or white potato. We're going to get into the different types of potatoes and which ones are best for which things in a little bit here. So anything you have would work. Russets, baby potatoes, fingerlings. We're going to talk about all those different varieties. And so through the magic of Zoom and TV and all that, we're going to cook those for about 45 minutes, and we're actually going to start on our second thing. So let's see. The average person in the U.S. consumes how many pounds of potatoes a year? What'd they say? What'd they say on that poll? Let's see. Well, we did have a lot of baked potato eaters, didn't we? Okay. Tater tots, I'm with you on that one, too. We're going to go to the second one, which is, some people said, 68 pounds. Well, guess what? You are not correct. But those of you that have said 117 are correct. Give yourselves a hand. 117 pounds for the average American. Irish people, twice that much. No, of course, right? Okay, we're going to go down to poll number 3. And we do have a picture here in case some of you don't know. And will that zoom in on that there?
We have a three tie. Hold on. Yep.
Oh, can you see? Oh, you can probably see it. I can't see because the poll is up. But that is a famous picture called the Potato Eaters, because potatoes are a staple of many peasants' lives. And this was done by, nobody guessed it, Van Gogh. Van Gogh, very, very famous painting there of potatoes. All right, number 4. Our number 4 poll said the world's largest potato producer. Let's see what you know. Wow. I think everybody's going to learn something today because the answer is China. Would you have thought that? I never thought of potatoes being grown in China. But actually, yes, we do grow a lot here in the United States, and a lot of them stay here, but we also export them. and lots of potatoes end up in other parts of the world. Actually, the state of Idaho, of course, is the biggest potato producer here in the United States, and they're known for their russet potatoes. All right, poll number five coming up. The potato was the first vegetable ever grown in outer space. And that is true, it was. It was the first thing that they actually grew in space to see if they could actually start vegetation on other planets. And so the potato was the first one that was grown in space. And actually, I'm going to show you at the end today how to grow potatoes yourself. And so that's a really great idea. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to start the next recipe while I go on. We're going to actually talk about sweet potatoes and yams first, because our next recipe uses sweet potatoes. How many here have eaten sweet potatoes? Raise your hand if you've eaten a sweet potato. I can see some of you. Yep, lots of people. How many have ever eaten a yam? Okay, I'm seeing some of this. I don't know, have I? You probably haven't, even though in the United States, a lot of these are labeled as yams. Yams are actually much bigger. They're much darker. They have a much woodier surface, and they actually are not as sweet as sweet potatoes. They're a much starchier vegetable. So actually, most people in the United States have not eaten yams. They have eaten sweet potatoes, which have been referred to as yams. So you just want to make sure that you're smart enough to know the difference. And so what we're going to do is we're actually going to put this big, large sweet potato, once we pierce it a few times, into the microwave by the magic of TV. And voila, here we have it. We have a beautiful sweet potato. I love to do these for dinner because they're so nutritious and delicious. We're going to cut this open here. Okay. And we're actually going to put this in our bowl over here because we're actually going to make a filling for a quesadilla. This is going to be a black bean and sweet potato quesadilla. And so I'm just going to squeeze out the insides there. Of course, we want to usually keep the skin in our recipes if we can when we're using potatoes. But sweet potato skins, when they wouldn't go too well inside this quesadilla. So I'm just going to scoop that out easily. You could wait till it cools off, but not me. I like to do them while they're cooked. Okay, so we're just going to take this and we're just going to mash this up a little bit. Nice and, oh, it smells. I wish you had smell-o-vision. It smells great. And so we have this sweet potatoes that we're going to mash. Of course, these are full of vitamin A. Any orange fruit or vegetable is very high in vitamin A, which is excellent for your night vision. Also good for lots of other things in your body, but we have lots of vitamin A in there. And then we're going to take a can of black beans. These have been rinsed and then put back in the can, but these are actually black beans, and we've had live on beans before, and so we're going to put that whole can in there. Of course, beans are a great source of protein, a cheap source of protein, a great way to have a vegetarian night by having a dish made with beans as opposed to very expensive meats. And so we want to make sure that we're using our dollars, our food dollars, wisely. And of course, our clients at the food bank receive a lot of beans during distribution. And so it's a great way to use all of these. And so we're just going to mix those in there. They don't have to be completely mashed. If you're a real purist, you might want to smash them down. Okay, and so we're going to put that in there.
Question, Maryann, did you rinse those beans?
I did rinse those beans. I did mention that. Maybe you didn't hear me, but I said
I'm sorry. And why should we rinse them?
Well, we're going to try to get rid of some of the sodium that they're packed in. And so we want to make sure that we get rid of that. And we want to make sure that we're being as healthy as we can. Also, there's like a liquid in there that's kind of gets pretty murky looking just from leaching the color out of the beans. And so it's kind of thick and black. And so we just want to make sure that they're rinsed off and we use those. Then we're going to put in a tablespoon of low sodium taco mix. Of course, low sodium diet's better for you because we have a real problem with high blood pressure in this country. And so we want to make sure that I will just cut that with my little knife. And we're just going to put a tablespoon in. And we're actually going to be making eight of these quesadillas, which is actually 2 full ones. And we want to make sure we level that off, give you a little extra taco seasoning, because this looks like a spicy crowd. You a spicy crowd out there? Heidi says yes, but you don't look. Yeah, okay, Heidi, yeah. We'll take that and we're gonna mix that in. And then we have whole wheat tortillas that we're gonna actually put this on. And so we're gonna take our whole wheat tortillas, always focusing on eating more whole wheat products, whole wheat containing all the nutrients that your grains provide. And so we're gonna take one of these. We're going to actually put it in our pan, which we've, it's a Teflon pan, so I don't need to really put anything on it as far as spray or anything. We're gonna put that on there. And then we're gonna actually take our spatula and put some of this mix onto that quesadilla and take it in there and just spread it around. So why eat potatoes? Potatoes have gotten a really bad rap nutritionally in the last so many years. And the reason is because a lot of people are trying to stay away from starches and carbohydrates, but you know, your body needs those for energy. And so it's really, you know, not real good to cut them all out of your diet, okay? A healthy diet includes a balanced diet. And so you wanna make sure that you're eating all colors of fruits and vegetables to get all your nutrients. And so what we're gonna do is we have that in the pan. Okay, we spread it out. We're gonna put another one on top. And by the magic of television and my assistant Maria, we're gonna actually cook that on the real stove since we had a little tiny electrical problem this morning in the food bank kitchen. Okay, so let's look at some more things today. We wanna look at various types of potatoes. How many times have you ever made mashed potatoes and as you whipped them, they turned into glue? Has anybody ever had that happen? I've had that happen. Or you made a potato salad and it turned out to be mashed potato salad. The potatoes just fell apart. They didn't hold their shape. Well, that's because there's a lot of different kinds of potatoes out there. And so we're gonna look at them and what you can use those for. And so the first one we have here, anybody know what that one's called? It's a big long one.
Is it russet?
It is, it's a russet Burbank potato. They are oval shaped, go Nelly. They have a rough brown skin. They're usually labeled as baking potatoes in the store. So they have a thicker skin with a fluffy white center. And because they're starchy, they actually bake very well. Okay, they're good for pan frying, mashed, and French fries are really good made out of these types of potatoes. There's actually three different types of potatoes as far as varieties, and they are, trying to get that to stick there. They are starchy, waxy, and then a combination of the two. And so they actually have different textures inside, which make them better or worse for certain types of foods. Our next ones are red skins. And red skins have thin skins on them as opposed to the thick skin of a russet, which means it stays firm through the cooking. They're waxy with a creamy, moist texture. They have a little bit of a sweeter flavor and they hold their shape. So they're great for things like soups because they won't break down. They're great for things like potato salad because they'll hold their shape. And so those are really, really a good potato. I love using reds. Then we have your all-purpose white. These are the ones you see in the store. They're probably the cheapest ones that you can purchase. They're the ones I'm using today. They actually have a very thin skin with a nuttier flavor. They actually stay firm like the red potatoes through the cooking. And they're great for all kinds of ways of cooking. Steaming, soups, French fries, anything where you want it to hold its shape and not break down. You want to use an all-purpose white potato. Of course, since they're white inside, potatoes have a lot of potassium. In fact, they have more potassium than a banana, which a lot of people don't think about, but any kind of fruit or vegetable that is primarily white has a lot of potassium. And so that's why we're always saying eat a rainbow of vegetables, because that's how you're gonna get all the nutrients you need. Here we have some yellow potatoes, kind of like Yukon Golds. If you've ever purchased those at the store, they look really good inside. They're waxy, a waxy type of potato, velvety, moist. They have a subtle sweetness and a buttery, creamy flavor. And they're great baked, mashed, and salads, soups, grilled. These are the main types of potatoes that we actually have in the United States. Here we have something new and different, purple potatoes. These actually have a medium skin and are a little more earthy flavored. They also call them blue potatoes, so sometimes they may look a little more blue than purple. You can use them baked, roasted, salad, steamed, microwaved. These actually hold their shape well too, and so they're a great one. Plus, they look awfully pretty in a potato salad. You can actually mix them up. Here we have what are called petites. Petite is another variety of potato. They're also called new potatoes, and these are just now coming out. The first little harvests that are coming out now are new potatoes. They're classified by size and by maturity. So they're harvested early, and so they're real tender. They're the perfect size. They're little. You cook them whole. They're similar to their counterparts because they have new potato petites in every type of potato, okay? But they actually have more concentrated flavors, okay? Because they're smaller, okay? And you can bake, roast, pan fry, steam, or microwave those. And then last but not least, we have things that are called fingerlings. And don't they look like your finger? They do. And these are actually 2 to 4 inches long. They're waxy and firm with a nutty, buttery flavor. And a lot of times they call them French fingerlings. So if you want to have something special, you can have them French or something like that. They have names like Russian banana, purple Peruvian, and these are great, baked, roasted. You mostly want to keep these smaller potatoes whole because they are delicious. All right, so those are our 7 types of potatoes. Oops, that one didn't cut them on. Okay, 7 types of potatoes. And so while my chef Maria is flipping over that quesadilla, we are going to look at those potatoes and finish those up, those buffalo wing potatoes. All right, so I have another bowl here. We're gonna actually make some sauce. And so we're gonna make a hot wing sauce here. How many of you have ever done wings at home? Lots of hands going up, making wings at home. So you have your favorite sauce, use it on there. Sometimes you can buy something that says buffalo wing sauce. Other times, all you have to do is take some butter and some hot sauce. We got Texas Pete in the house today. Texas Pete is coming for our potatoes. And so we're gonna take, back to our first recipe, 1/4 cup of butter melted. I'm gonna do that in the microwave by magic. And of course, if you wanna cut down on the butter, you can always do that and just use the hot sauce. But of course, if you want the real taste, a little butter will get hurt. And so we're gonna take that butter, we're gonna melt it down. Then we're gonna add our hot sauce to it. What's your favorite kind of hot sauce? Anybody have a brand they really love?
Sriracha.
I'm not a hot sauce person. What do you got there, Nathan?
Frank's Red Hot.
Oh, Frank's Red Hot in the house. I see a few nods. Frank's Red Hot. And so we're actually gonna take 1/2 cup of this. Oh, baby. And we're gonna actually get our potatoes. Oh, look at that, by the magic of TV, those roasted potatoes. Do they look good? They have a nice crunch to them. I can see they're nice and brown. So we're gonna take those. We're just gonna toss our hot sauce. Yeah, looking good. So lots of other reasons to eat potatoes. They have fiber to them. Of course, they also have some protein, which most people don't think about. They actually have, one medium potato has as much protein as 3 ounce hamburger. Is that crazy? Yeah, they actually have protein in them. So here we have our butter, and we're gonna mix our hot sauce in there. Oh, baby. Nathan, my assistant, is very excited about lunch today. Aren't you, Nathan?
Yes, I am.
He is. Okay, so we're just gonna mix that together. And by getting another bowl from my assistant, I'm gonna toss them in the bowl. Oh, smell of this stuff. It all smells great.
Maryann, do you deliver?
Do I deliver? DoorDash does. We just had DoorDash here today at the food bank delivering to some of our clients who can't get to the locations. And so We're always trying to show clients and pantry leaders how to use different foods, because it's important that they know how to tell their clients why to take all these things. Now, potatoes are something they get almost every delivery that I've seen, especially in things like our military shares. I know they get sweet potatoes and regular potatoes every month. And so they're like, well, I can't use that many potatoes. Guess what? I have a feeling they'll be asking for an extra box. Only one per person. Here we go. We're going to pour that hot sauce on those golden potatoes. Ready? Here I go. Going into it. She's going into the bowl. And we're going to just toss those. These would be great for a party. You know how expensive chicken wings are when everybody wants to go to town on them? Here is a cheaper alternative and gives you the same feels. And so we have these potatoes here. Our plate's soon ready to come up here.
Maryann, would that be plant-based chicken wings then?
Would that be what?
Plant-based chicken wings?
We're gonna just call these delicious. So there we go. We have a nice serving. I think Nathan wants a few more on his dish. Oh, look at that. Does that not look good? Smells good. A great new way to use potatoes. Next poll, they're gonna say we want buffalo wing potatoes. All right, and our other, by the magic of Zoom and Maria, we have our quesadilla. We have our black bean. Oh yeah, what about our cheese? Oops, forgot the cheese, but guess what? We can always add that at the end. And you can also put a little sour cream on them if you like. You can throw some cilantro on there if you're not like me and think it tastes like soap. But yeah, you could actually melt the cheese in there, which would be great. Whatever you like, but this is also a great dinner idea. We're gonna try to get that one right off there. Oh, she's good, this lady's good. I'm gonna tell you what I think. I have not tried these yet. And because I'm in charge, I get to. Wow. I would make these. I did make these. Hey, that's great. Okay, so last but not least, you have potatoes at your house. All of a sudden they start sprouting these crazy looking bumps. What has happened to them? Well, they're just listening to Mother Nature, who says it is time to grow. And so if you have potatoes like this in the spring in your house, you can actually grow potatoes yourself at home. All you need to do is cut off these, what are called eyes, those little bumps that start to grow. With every piece of potato you cut, you want to keep an eye and you want to plant them about 6 inches deep in some dirt. Cover them over, amazing. You can grow your own potatoes. It's easy peasy, people. You're providing for yourselves, and we like that. Also, if you want to grow a sweet potato, I'm so proud of this. This potato was at home, wasn't looking so good, and I said, I'm going to grow some sweet potato slips. And so what I did was cut that potato in half, put some toothpicks into it, suspended it in a glass of water, and lo and behold, do you see that? Those are called sweet potato slips. So all I need to do is break that off. You see the roots there? I don't know if we can see the roots. Can you see the roots there? So for every one of those little things that's growing, I can get a sweet potato plant. And each plant will give me mega potatoes. Free food, people. Jump on board. And so that's what I have for you today in Maryann's Live. Please join us. Please join us again next month as we celebrate Hunger Action Month. Also, please complete the poll that you'll find after the Zoom is ended. And so thanks everybody for coming and joining me. These recipes will be on our website, and see you soon.
Thanks, Maryann.
There can't be much to do. So now they have blue ones too. We don't care what they look like, we'll eat them. Any way they can fit on our plate. Every way we can conjure to eat them. We're delighted and think they're just great. Potato, 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 potato.